Fick's first law of diffusion is a fundamental principle in the field of physics and engineering that quantitatively describes how particles move from regions of higher concentration to lower concentration. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. Named after Adolf Fick, a 19th century German physician who first formulated the law, this mathematical relationship serves as the cornerstone for understanding diffusion processes in various systems. The law stated mathematically as the following: where J is the flux or the amount of substance passing through a unit area per unit time, D is the diffusion coefficient, and dCdx is the concentration gradient along the direction of X. In the context of gas exchange in the lungs, Fick's first law can be employed to explain how oxygen and carbon dioxide move between the alveolar air spaces in the lungs and the pulmonary capillaries. The alveoli are tiny air sacs in the lungs where gas exchange occurs, and the pulmonary capillaries are tiny blood vessels that wrap around the alveoli. When you inhale air, it flows into the lungs and fills the alveoli. This air has a higher concentration of oxygen compared to the blood in the pulmonary capillaries. Conversely, the blood in these capillaries has a higher concentration of carbon dioxide than the air in the alveoli. According to Fick's first law, oxygen will diffuse from the alveoli into the blood, and carbon dioxide will diffuse from the blood into the alveoli, both moving along their respective concentration gradients. Several factors can influence this diffusion process, including the thickness and surface area of the respiratory membrane, as well as the diffusion coefficients for both oxygen and carbon dioxide. Diseases like emphysema or pulmonary fibrosis can alter these factors, thereby affecting the efficiency of gas exchange. So, as you can see, Fick's first law serves as the foundation for understanding the mechanics of diffusion in various systems, including the complex and vital process of gas exchange in the lungs. It quantitatively captures how molecules move from regions of high to low concentration, which in the context of respiration, ensures that oxygen is efficiently taken up by the blood for cellular use while simultaneously allowing for the removal of waste products like CO2. This law illustrates the physiological mechanisms that allow for effective respiration and, by extension, the sustenance of life itself. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching, have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.